says nature bats last.
Right, but we can straighten it out. We can straighten it out with our knowledge.
With
now.
What?
We can replant the planet. We can replant it with our scientific ability. It fits right into the platform. It works.
Still wrapping at the cataclysm?
Well, it's here.
It's coming up the driveway.
Oh.
Hartley's coming. The chick that Bruce sent out to check on the house to see if everything was all right.
Oh, yes.
She's coming now up the driveway. So we've got to do something to get it all together.
Let's give her life.
It's together enough. Everything is okay.
She We're all going to be back on Front Street. Hello? Hello? Oh, it's Hartley. Oh,
my God, I'm on land. I'm seeing in the air.
Where are you?
I'm fine. Look at the penny I found on your door.
Out here?
Hundreds of them. Financial disaster.
Hello,
in the beginning.
Hartley, this is Baron.
Hello.
Susie. Paul.
Hi.
Chris.
Mm-hmm.
And Tiffy up on the altar.
You're not going to sacrifice them, are you?
Not until later.
Well, we're going to deal with those people up there because they're the only people that are worth listening to.
Well, how can you decide who's worth listening to?
You can decide.
How do you know I'm not worth listening to? You haven't even talked to me yet.
I know. I can listen to you. And you don't tell.
Come to your room.
Oh, thank you. Let me get that first.
Good.
Come
first.
On.
See you in a little while. Take care of the altar while I'm out.
Area.
Are those some of the deities, or is that the staff?
Those are some of the most beautiful people in the world in there.
Really? Well, I better hurry up and slip into something spiritual.
That looks plenty holy to me. Rainbow Bridge clue.
What is with the Ten of Cups? Well, it's looking a bit better.
Nice room.
It's Bruce's mother's.
I hope she didn't die in a bed. Oh, that's all I need.
Isn't it? Ten of Cups is almost right on. You got the rainbow, all the people dancing around happily. Except that, I mean, it's like watching the Joshua Light show, right?
God.
And you got to pay $2.50 to get in to see it. If you eat all the right foods and you do all the right do, they might let you peek. I mean, is that what the Rainbow Bridge is all about?
Yeah, I'll get the wizard to wrap the whole thing down to you.
All the rainbow bridges is a bridge between here and here and here, between the lower self and the higher self.
You've got to tell me how you got Bruce to scam you to come here. How did you work it?
Well, I didn't do anything. It was completely cosmic. Listen, a friend of mine met him at a party, right? And he was all drugged and doped up and wondering, mumbling and saying, I've got this meditation center on Maui and a blah, 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 blah. And the guy was saying, are you crazy? You're giving all that people all that bread to go out there and live in your mother's house and fuck it all up and do nothing with it? Send somebody out to check. And I have just the person.
It's so perfect. I was so terrified of what type of person you'd be.
Yeah, well, I didn't know what was going on here. I thought it'd be Harry Krishna for days.
Well, they're doing that.
Well, I figured a little free vacation, I'd check it out. If it was too much of a drag, I'd split.
Did you meet Bruce?
Yeah, I met him in Apple Valley.
Ah.
It wasn't exactly...
What did you think of him?
Well, he's a little nervous.
Chuck's making a cosmic surfing movie.
Oh, you're going to film the surfers?
Not
I mean,
so much
not, not just them, but I mean the cosmic surfers.
When we were starting, Bruce wanted this whole kind of image-building thing of doing a trip on the consciousness of surfing in Hawaii. And so that was our first project out here.
It's not the same as everybody thinks it is. It's not a bikini beach party where the surfer's just lying out on the beach drinking beer, bumming around with the evening orgies. It's more that they've been through all the changes ahead of everybody else. They've been through yoga and Zen and pure food way before.
Oh!
All right.
Leslie. Michael.
Oh, God.
Man,
oh,
it's good to see you guys. Leslie.
I didn't think you was going to make it, man.
I didn't think I was going to make it either. A lot of things came down between then and now, but I made it.
All right.
What happened?
Well, I was at the airport in Honolulu. They kept me for a couple hours, put me in a room, asked me questions. I didn't know what I was there for. I didn't know if they knew me. I didn't know anything. Finally, after a couple hours, they cut me loose. Good came straight over here to see you guys. And you guys look like, I don't know what's happening. What's going on?
Well, David and Barry just left. The surf's been flat. We've been doing nothing but just dragging out, you know, and doing our scene.
I guess that's why the Dow brought me here at this time. Some for us, because
really,
you came through for us. I want you to open up these panels here and here. Take this knife.
Oh, for sure, brother.
I need to smoke a joint. This is ganja from Vietnam.
You won't believe what's going on out here. Hurry up and get it together. Okay, I'm coming.
You got that? All right, Mike. Uh-huh, look at this. Afghanistan. Primo pollen. Just look at that.
Neptune's transiting Scorpio right now.
Scorpio. Everything's Scorpio around here. We can't get away from Scorpio. There's Scorpio again. Well, if we're going to get this thing together, we really got to find out what makes her tick, where her head's at.
All we have to do is rechannel her energy, and that's very easy.
How about the Mercury? Let's start with the Mercury.
Well, the Mercury would be good, but the South Node would be easier.
Hi. Come and join us on our next exercise.
Are you up on your spiritual P.E.?
Now we'll all sit down. Easy pose, a full lotus if possible. Beautiful. Hands on shoulders, right in the center.
Oof. Right. Together, my shoulder hurts.
On the inhale, turn your upper part of your body to the right. And on the exhale, to the left. What?
My shoulder.
More.
No more.
Inhale. Hold. Exhale, and feel the energy run through your whole body.
Great hash, man.
Violet light is the purifying energy. That's what I want to do, channel the violet light to you. We have force fields around us, electromagnetic force fields, and there are centers that the Easterners, the Indians, call chakras, and they receive the pranic energy, those little globules of light that we see sometimes against the sun.
And that energy comes into our ether or spiritual bodies and then to our endocrine gland system and is funneled to the bloodstream to raise our vibration and purify us. So what we're doing is channeling to the spiritual body. Over past lifetimes and in this lifetime, negative thoughts and energies have built up, and the centers that receive, the third eye, the front pituitary, the pineal, the thyroid, and the thymus, they've been blocked off by negative thoughts and actions which form obstructions to the inflow of the cosmic energies. And channeling divine light, violet light, to that spiritual body, to those centers, speeds up the motion of the wheels, and they receive more, and everybody's vibration goes up.
What is all this freaking I'm hearing about my horoscope
doing?
Did my chart yet?
Yeah, I got it right here. Oh, what's been bothering you anyway?
It's been bothering me.
Yeah. You just want to know something about yourself personally?
Yeah.
Well, you've got the sun in Scorpio in the 12th, Scorpio rising, and the moon in Aquarius in the 3rd house.
Uranus in the 7th house,
Mars
in the
7th
house. You don't know too much about the planets. Well, the 12th house is the house of limitations, sorrows, self-undoing. It's like energy that doesn't do a person any good. 3rd house is communication, 7th house is long-term arrangements.
Which means your sex life is prone to all kinds of trips, freaky trips, bisexual trips, insane trips, drug trips.
Wes, is this my chart? It's probably Hartley's.
Oh, there's your name right there.
Oh, okay. Did you get it all right, the times and everything?
Yeah, I did it 3 times. I don't make too many mistakes with horoscopes, except reading them sometimes.
Mars is in the 7th house, which means all your energy is there in the sign of Gemini, which is the intellect, and it's also the schizophrenic sign, the twins, both sides happening. It's pretty well conjunct Saturn, about 4 degrees away in the 8th house, the sex house, so it all works together in the same house, which means freaking is the nature, although there's been a lot of sex bummers in your life, especially with a Venus in Virgo. A lot of lessons have been learned with sex bummers and freaking, but freaking is truly your nature.
What is all this freaking in my chart?
Well, you have the chart of a freak.
I don't want to have the chart of a freak.
Well, you probably refuse to see it because the sun's in the 12th house. You see only the limits of freaking rather than the real enjoyment behind it. Study some of the higher things. Get a little energy in from higher people. Be a little more expressive of a lot of the good trips that are happening.
Who do I get the most energy from?
Leos, really. Pisces would be good, but Leos would be even better. Virgos would be nice. You have Venus and Virgo, you know.
What does all that mean, Venus and Virgo and all that?
Well, Venus is the love nature, and Virgo is the sign of prudence. It just means your love nature is kind of prudent, you know. Every time you ball, it's like the first time. You know?
That must not be my chart. Somebody else's, obviously.
No, this is your chart, but you don't see your own trip too well. With the sun in the 12th house, you see more your limitations than your positive parts.
This is the most depressing place on Earth.
This place? This place here?
And you, how many places have you been?
A lot of places. I used to be, right? But I've never been any place, right? So then somehow, mysteriously, I went a lot of places. But it's so depressing because this paradise is so completely fucked up. I mean, you sit around New York City and everybody says, oh, got to get out of the buildings, the noise, the clatter, the bang. And you come someplace like this, and I see people living behind barbed wire on naval bases, little children playing on swings and barbed wire.
It's everywhere.
No, but that's the whole problem, man, because California was supposed to be the land of wealth and promise, the land of milk and honey, the great migration.
There is no land of wealth and promise.
I know.
If you believe that, you're a fool.
You just have to hope that the divine plan has a good end.
What divine plan? You are the fucking divine plan. You keep giving it away to everybody. No one's going to save you. I mean, you're going to sit back and say there's a divine plan.
Krishna.
Exactly. I mean, what divine plan? You're the divine plan. You make the divine plan.
Well, then obviously that'll happen.
Well,
what is happening and what has been happening? The same bullshit the whole time. Right? It always goes on. Everybody sits there and goes, bullshit.
Then
what bullshit?
You're just afraid of taking responsibility for anything.